Hi everyone, welcome to this new studio vlog. I took the charcoal drawing from the end of the last vlog and painted over it in Procreate to make the print for this month's Patreon reward. I also printed out some postcards using the new printer, and I created the postcard for July, which is a Huhu beetle waiting for the bus on a rainy day here in Wellington. Here is a time-lapse video of the process. July 28th, and I just wanted to drop in and talk a little bit about my pencil sharpeners. I have a few, I'm sure these people have a lot more, but over the years I've amassed a small collection of these in the effort to find the best pencil sharpener. I've got all kinds, from the very simple sort of small plastic and metal ones, to some from different brands. This one is from Daiso, and it's supposed to have one of those fancy ratchet mechanisms in it. And this one's alright, but you know, still not quite what I would be after. And then I've got a couple more of these basic metal ones, and then a long point metal sharpener as well. So yeah, I've got quite a few, and I'm sure that I have some more tucked away somewhere. But the thing that I have found is that quite often my pencil leads snap. And I do know that this is a problem with the pencils that I use sometimes, so we'll just move those out of the way. Because I use a lot of Prismacolor Premier pencils. So these are my main coloured pencils that I use most of the time. And occasionally you tend to get one where it has been dropped maybe, or damaged, and the core has been broken kind of up in the pencil because it's been dropped, and so it continuously breaks. But sometimes I just end up with leads that snap when I sharpen them. So I did an Amazon order recently, and you can get this particular pencil sharpener locally, but I was ordering something else and this pencil sharpener was on sale for half the price, so I grabbed it, and it is a Prismacolor Premier coloured pencil sharpener specifically for these pencils. So I thought I will give it a go, because I've tried just about everything else, well, probably not, but you know, all of the things that are available to me I have tried, so I thought, why not try this? Let's have a look at it. It says choose your sharpening angle, wide or narrow, and it has a lid so the shavings can't escape, so that is quite good if you're going to be taking it out and about. But it is quite big as well, it's quite a big sharpener. It says designed to sharpen Prismacolor pencils to a perfect point. Sharpener cover keeps shavings inside. Translucent casing shows when sharpener is ready to empty, and high quality steel blade. Okay, let's open this up and see if it will sharpen my pencils a little better. Okay. So here we go, here is the sharpener, and if I open it this way, we can see that there are indeed two different sized, no, or are they the same size? They might be like that different angle. Oh, I see, there's two illustrations here. If I turn it in the light, you can see it. So this one must give you a really fine, longer point, and this one maybe a slightly shorter point. So let's give this a go and see how it works out. Right, I'm going to choose a fairly blunt pencil, and I think I'm going to start with the shorter blunt, not blunt, that's the wrong word, the shorter, fatter kind of point here, so we're just going to try this out. Ooh, that's looking good so far. That is very nice. I've got a few kind of like shaving bits that are coming off the side there. I'm just going to do it one more time. And that is just about perfect. See if I can get that in focus there. There we go. Okay, so taking the same pencil now, I'm going to try the other side that will give us the long point, I think. So we'll try that and see how that goes. That's pretty good too. Kind of thought it was going to break there, but it didn't. And here we go. Yeah, we've got a little bit of jaggedness happening here, but that point feels pretty good. Okay, I'm going to sharpen a few more and test these out, and I will be back with the results in just a second. All right. I have managed to sharpen these pencils very nicely. They've all come to a beautiful fine point, so in that regards I'm very happy with them. One thing I did notice is the actual lid, this lid that's meant to close like this. It's got one of these very, very flimsy plastic hinges on it, which I am not sure if it's going to last all that long. I feel like I will end up having to tape this down at some point, because I feel like that is possibly going to break. It's just got this very thin kind of bend in the plastic there. But the other thing that I thought I would check out is how easy it is to empty, because now it is full of pencil shavings. So let's give that a go. Right, for this I am going to use this little origami paper box that I learned how to make from Louise over at Coffee Tea Paper, and I really enjoy having this in my journaling kit because it's quite easy to take out and about. So let's just empty all of our pencil shavings into here and see if I can work out how to empty this. That's how you empty it. All right. But that looks nice and bright and colorful, doesn't it? I'm just gonna pick all this up. Right, so now I know, and now you know, to be careful when you're doing that. So yes, this is portable. Yes, you can use it when you're out and about. I'm lucky that hinge didn't break flying that way. But yeah, there's not really a lot of indications to let you know exactly how to open it. But it's done and it's good, so that is fine. Let's have a look at the pencils and see how they're going to work. Right, I've got a swatch page in here somewhere. Here we go. I'm just going to swatch down the bottom here. I just want to see how the points actually perform on the paper, because I quite often get the points snapping off because the leads of these are so soft, and sometimes a little bit crumbly. So let's just try this out and see how it goes. Yeah, so we've got a little bit of a tiny snap there. Oh, try and focus. Yeah, so a little bit did come off, but normally it's much worse than that, so that is not bad. I'm gonna try a darker one. Okay, yeah, that's not bad. I'm pretty happy with that. Try a couple of others over here. This one has been a problem pencil, so we'll try this one. I still get the tiny little bit of crack, so you don't get the very fine sharp point, but you can turn the pencil and then you can get the sharper side again. And I'm just going to try pressing down and shading a little bit with the sharpened pencil just to see how that reacts and whether that's going to split or crack. And that looks very good. Well, okay, so apart from the slightly flimsy cap and the difficulty I had in actually getting it apart in order to empty it, which I'm sure is actually probably just me, I really like this for the actual sharpening pencils. So getting the right sharpener for the right pencil, in this case at least, actually does make a difference. So if you use Prismacolor Premier coloured pencils and you see this when you're out and about and it's not too expensive, I would definitely say give it a go if you've had troubles like me. And yeah, definitely can recommend, I think. I will use it for a little while longer, and if anything changes, or you know, if I decide for whatever reason it starts acting a bit strange, I will update in a vlog at some point and let you know how this is going. Right, on to the next thing that came with my Amazon purchase. We'll just put this to one side. Now, this next purchase, in a way, was also kind of inspired by Louise. A little while back, she got a pencil case. And then there was the breakup with the pencil case happened, which was quite dramatic, and I definitely recommend going and checking out that video because it was dramatic but also hilarious. And I recently, I have to say, I've suffered my own pencil case breakup. It was quite sad, and I'm still recovering from that. But as it happens, you know, when you're recovering from such an experience, you start looking around and wondering, you know, how can I improve my situation? You know, how can I do better? And I'm sorry, Louise, but this might have happened. There we go. So I am now the owner of a Lihit Lab compact pen case. And I thought maybe this could help me get over my own sad situation. Which I'll insert a small clip of. So yeah, let's take this out and have a look. Right, so I'm sure maybe a lot of you have seen something like this before if you've not seen this exact case. It's basically a case that opens up like a book. There we go, we've got some packaging here, I'll cut this off in a second as well. And it has a padded section here that you can put some pens in if you've got like some special pens. Let me just zoom out a bit if I can. There we go. And on the side it's got some spaces for things like sticky notes and maybe a memo pad back here. What's this? I feel like that's an information card. There we go. I cannot read that, but there it is. And also silica gel. So my pencil case breakup was basically my drawing case. All of my pencils, everything that was in it. That case that I had those in was no longer working for me for various reasons. And I had an awful lot. Here's how much I had in that pen case. Now the ultimate reason for the breakup was that it failed, basically one of the components failed, but it also fit all of this, and so I started to think maybe I don't need all of this. I have all of the pencil leads that you could possibly want for mechanical pencils. I have not only the Tombow mono erasers but the refills for them. I mean, I don't need to keep those with me, or at least not two of them. I have this regular Tombow mono. I even have a water brush, which is good for urban sketching. And then also for urban sketching, I have these two colored pencils here. I think there might be a third one. I've got my markers for outlining, brown and black waterproof markers. And then I've got my various mechanical pencils. Some of which are really nice ones. These two wooden ones I just got from Daiso, and they've got coloured leads in them. So we've got those. Oh, and this one. And more pencil leads. A brush marker. A Kohinoor lead holder for very thick lead or charcoal. And a metal ruler. So all of that stuff I was carrying around with me, and I thought, you know what, I don't really need it. I don't need all of those things just for a small drawing kit. So I thought, we'll try out this case. And I'm just going to see if these things will fit in here. So I'm going to put my markers there, and then we probably really only need 0.3, 0.5, we probably don't even need the 0.3, but bear with me. It's sometimes hard to like break old habits. And then I'm going to put this Draftmatic 0.9 so we can have those. And then we should have an eraser, but do we need these? I feel like one. We don't need the rectangular one, that can stay at home. So already we've filled up that section quite nicely, so let's put these in here. Now this is always nice to have, the lead or the charcoal holder. I'm just going to put this over here in case we can fit that in. And for the mechanical pencils, seeing as I'm no longer going to be carrying this blue one with me, with the blue lead, I think we are only going to need leads for those pencils. 0.9. Oh, we'll want the B, I think. 0.9B, there we go. And what else do we have? Okay, so those are the only leads that I think I'm going to try carrying with me. And I am just going to put the ruler in there as well. There we go. So that's quite a reduction. I feel like this is going to be good for me though. Just have a very small sketching case that I can... Oh! The ruler doesn't fit. Maybe. Can we put it in here? Can we? Maybe. Just there. Okay, here we go. We'll move this over. Maybe if we slide the ruler down behind here. I mean, I don't need the ruler, but it's just nice to have, you know? Okay, so the ruler doesn't fit. That's fine. That makes our kit even more compact and easy to carry. So let's add our pencil leads. Now it doesn't close. And of course I can add extra things in this front pocket at some point, but let's have a look. Yes, that is going to close. Let's cut this off. Oh, and we've got another thing over here as well. Now, like I said with the old pencil case, a part of it failed and broke, but one of the reasons that I ended up being quite frustrated with it was that although I could fit all the things in it, it was actually quite difficult to get to the things, and I found out in the end I ended up not using a lot of those supplies anyway because they were all tucked behind in and underneath and they just never got used. So let's close this up and have a look. Yeah, I think that is absolutely perfect. It's quite compact and I do like how it expands a little bit even so, just to accommodate the things that are in there. But it still feels very small, and this will be quite lovely to pop in a bag and take out and about, and it won't take up too much space, and I will have everything that I need to do some quick sketches. Here we go.